G'day students, my name is Dr. Price. Today I'm going to teach you long division and short division. So we're looking at the question 461 divided by 3, and we're using base 10 material. This is special base 10 blocks that will stick to the whiteboard. So this is probably something you've done in class already, so this will be revision. And you need to know that teachers use different language sometimes. So the words that I use may be slightly different, but the meaning will be the same, and of course the answer will be the same. So let's have a look at the question. We have four hundreds here and here, and we're going to share them among three. This is the space where we have the three. Of course, we can share some of the hundreds. We can share three of them straight away. So using the written process, we do it this way. We say 4 divided by 3 is how many? How many can we share out? Well, everybody can have 1, so we write that at the top. And then we multiply to work out how many we have shared. 1 times 3 is 3. We'll put that under the 4 so we can take it away and look at how many are left. Of course, there's 1 left. So here's another 100. We can't share this one because that wouldn't be fair. All our shares have to be equal. So we're going to swap this or trade it. There's different words we can use, but we're going to swap it for 10 tens. So I'll just put these new tens up here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now we have a lot more tens. How many tens do we have? Well, in the written process, we take this 6 and we write it down here next to the 1 to show the number of tens. I can put labels here as well. Hundreds, tens, and ones. So we've shared the hundreds. Now we're sharing the tens, and this is 10 tens left over from the hundreds column with the 6 tens makes 16, and there's our 16 tens. Can we share 16 tens among 3? Yes, we can, and you have to use your 3 times number facts or times tables to work out the answer. So 16 shared among 3 means everybody will have 5 because 5 threes are 15. So let me do that quickly. 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then the third one the same. All right, so everybody has 150 so far, and that's what this shows, 105 tens. Last bit. Now we have 1 10 and 1 1 left over. We can't share this 10, so again we're going to swap it. Here I've got 10 ones. These 10 plus this one makes 11 ones. I should write that down. So I'm missing out a step here. 5 threes are 15. These are the tens that we shared out. We take that away. There will be 1 left. This 1 10, we write the 1 1 next to it to show 11 ones. That's what I've got here. Share 11 ones among 3. How many will each person receive? Well, the answer must be 3 because 3 threes are 9, and that will leave us with 2 left. So everybody gets 3. 3 threes are 9, and we have 2 left over, and that's what we call the remainder. So the blocks show us clearly everybody has 100, 5 tens and 3 ones are 153, and here are 2 left over. So that process, this written process here, is called long division, where we write all the numbers underneath. So I'm going to show you another question now, but we're going to do it using short division. So I'm going to change the numbers, and I'll just put a question here. So let's divide by 5, and we'll do 784. Okay. And we won't be using the blocks this time. So 700 divided by 5. How many can each one receive if we share 7 among 5? Well, everybody will have 100. 1 times 5 is 5. This time we don't write it down because this is short division. We keep it in our head and say if we shared out 5 and we have 7, how many will be left over? The answer is 2. So we put the 2 just here in front of the 8. Now we look at 28. This is tens. 28 tens shared among 5. Think of your 5 times table. 5 fives are 25. Which is less than that, so we can have 5 here. Everybody gets 5 tens. 5 fives are 25. There will be 3 left. So again, we put a little number, we put a 3 next to the 4. Last bit, this is the ones, 34 shared among 5. Think of your 5 times table again. The answer will be 6, because 6 fives are 30, and there will be a remainder of 4. One last step I'll show you, which can be very useful when you're doing this, is to reverse the process to check your answer. So 156 5 times will equal how much? If we're correct, it'll be almost the same as this. I'll show you what I mean in a moment. So we do 5 sixes are 30, 5 fives are 25, and 3 is 28, 5 ones are 5, and 2 is 7. The last thing we have is a remainder 4, so we'll add 4 and we get the answer 784, which is the same as the number that we started with. So that's long division and short division. I hope this has helped you. I've been talking quite quickly, so you might need to go back and rewind the video to see some of the steps again, but I look forward to talking to you again on another video.